Hello, Phil here from Wings of Pegasus, and welcome to another analysis video. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe. So on the agenda tonight, we have Fanny, and this is going to be coming from 1972. And if this video doesn't get blocked, I'll be very surprised, because Fanny means something totally different over here in the UK. But we're going to continue with it. This is going to be their performance of their track called Ain't That Peculiar. So let's get Fanny up on screen and see how they get on. I'm just going to jump in here because there's going to be a solo coming up, I think, the way that we're kind of leading into it. But straight off the bat, you can tell that these ladies know exactly what they're doing, just because of those elements that come in, like that dynamic change from the intro into the verse. So many bands forget dynamics and that change. There's something deeper going on here. And then when you start to listen to the fact that the vocal comes in, and that's June on vocals, June Millington, with the vocal that's so spot on pitch wise, and then also the backing harmonies that come in as well. So you've got this really solid rhythm section, and then layer by layer, it's just put on to just make an amazing cake. Once you finish with all those layers, that transition into half time, just when you're starting to get into that groove and settle into that full time, just changing up to half time just makes it so much more interesting and just takes you down a different avenue on that journey. Some really solid bass work here by Jean Millington as well, and that's June's sister. And they started their first band in high school, and they were called the Svelts, I think. And once that band disbanded, I think Alistair Burr played drums in that band, which we can see here. This is Alice on drums, and she went off with another guitarist to make another all-female band, and they were called Wild Honey. Further down the line, the Millington sisters joined up with Wild Honey, they joined the band, and they were actually all going to give it up, because around this time in the early 70s, 1972, this video is, we can tell from their sound, they're just a really classic rock sound. But around these times, it was such a male-orientated sound and genre. So their last ever gig was going to be at an open mic night. And it just so happened that on that night, Richard Perry's secretary was in attendance and saw these ladies play and was really impressed. And Richard Perry, by the way, was a record producer for Warner Brothers Records. Records back at the time. And he was actually looking for an all-female band. So his secretary said, I've seen this amazing band, we've got to sign them. So they ended up signing these ladies when they were called Wild Honey. When they then signed to the label, I think maybe the reason that they're not as well known as they could have been and maybe should have been is because they decided to change their name from Wild Honey to Fanny. And for me, it's one of those things that I don't know why they changed the name. They say that it was obviously there was no sexual connotation at all intended. But the problem is that if you don't know the band and you just see it on a bit of paper, you won't necessarily know that. And you might just write them off as just a bit of a joke because of the name of the band. But they meant it really as something that meant like a free spirit in terms of having that female spirit. And that's the angle they're going for. But maybe that didn't translate and it wouldn't have translated certainly over here in the UK. Another thing that changed when they got signed was that the original lead singer and percussionist called Bree Brandt, she was sacked. The label got rid of her because I think they saw that June could sing and play guitar as well, and they maybe thought, why do we need this person who can sing, or why do we need two lead singers in the band? So they really streamlined it. Maybe money was a reason for doing that. It usually is the case, but maybe it was just going in a particular direction with the sound that the label wanted. So this is now the band that we see with these four ladies performing here, and there's so many cool elements in here, like I mentioned, with the harmonies changing up into half time, but also the whole arrangement, the way that everything drops out for the verse so that June's vocals just cut through even more, and then when we start to get into the chorus it all dynamically just goes up another level. But let's get back into this performance. I just want to quickly jump in to just say, listen to that dynamic change coming out of the end of that solo into the verse. Rewind it if you need to. It is so well controlled and it is so professionally done, so well done, better than lots of guys that around at the time could do. That slide guitar solo, you can see that she actually changed her vibrato during that solo to more of a frantic vibrato, and you can get that comparison and also that contrast from when she was playing slide earlier in the song, where she had a really slow, deliberate vibrato. So a really great indication of her control with that slide, just giving that guitar a different voice. I always say that playing and singing at the same time doubles the difficulty. In this case with June, what we've got is not playing chords, she's just muting those strings and just strumming those strings, adding that percussive element into the mix while she's singing. It really does help to keep the composition driving forward from that percussive standpoint, whilst at the same time not compromising that lead vocal. We've still got a really clean lead vocal here because it's not competing with that rhythm guitar. Really helps with the dynamics. And by the way, really clean vocal sound we've got here. No reverb, no delay, just June's voice. But let's just get into this last 30 seconds. I think the end of the video cuts out, so I'm going to stop it when we get to like 4:59. Can't do without you. Do, 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 do. Now every chance you get, you seem to hurt me more and more. With each hurt, I make my love much stronger than before. I know flowers grow through rain, but how can love grow through pain? Hey! Yeah! Yeah! There we go. I'm going to have to stop it there because it will cut out. It's a shame that we get this really big box for the next video. I think you can edit that so it's a little bit smaller so you can still see the video in the background. But anyway, it would be great to watch this all the way through and maybe see how they finish the track, because everything's super tight. I'm sure that they've got something worked out at the end that would just be a really cool way to end the track. But just the track in general, there's so many different elements, because we've got those harmony vocals that are coming in that aren't harmonizing that lead vocal line. They're coming in with oohs and ahs and different melodies that just make it more interesting, because especially when you've got two or three singers like we have here that are all competent singers in their own right, or great singers in their own right, when they all come together, it means that you can just take the melody to so many different places, just with the backing vocals, but then also with that lead vocal as well. And this is just the video that I got sent to have a look at. So if there is a version of this that is in full, if you could let me know in the comments, that'd be great. Just put a link in the comments underneath this video, and I'll put that extra link in the description if it gets sent to me, so that people watching this video can see this version, but also the full version if it is out there. But these ladies have got everything that you look for in those top bands in terms of having those harmonies, three-part harmonies. Very few bands actually can pull that off, and having that overall tightness as well, having a great song, that appreciation of dynamics that's in there, individual playing ability on their instruments. So it looks like they had everything that they needed. Maybe it was harder than Richard thought it would be at the time to get an all-female band out there, or maybe it was just literally the band name. Certainly over here in the UK, that would not have gone down well, this band name, especially if you hadn't listened to them and just judged them on their band name. You might think that it's a joke when it isn't really a joke. So maybe they weren't too well known in the early 70s, but it's great that we can get them up on screen now and just have a look at them and see how good they were, just as an overall outfit, just an overall band. So many great elements going on here. But thank you so much for suggesting this video for me to take a look at, and keep those suggestions coming in the comments below. Let me know what you guys think, and if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe, and I'll see you guys at the next one. Rock!